using the Laplace transform to solve the initial value problem, dy over dt plus 3y equals 13sin2t, and you are given the condition that is y of 0 equals 6. So by the transform of a derivative theorem, you have, so dy over dt is the same as y prime, so you will have s to the first times capital Y of s minus s to the 0 times y of 0. So you always start with s to the power of the derivative times capital Y of s, and then subtract out to s to the 0. So now for this one, plus 3 times, so you have no derivative here, which means that we have s to the 0 times capital Y of s, always times capital Y of s for the first term, okay? And the Laplace transform of 13sin2t, so 13 is just constant, let's rewrite it. And L of sin2t is equal to 2 over s squared plus 4. Let me combine this together. So I have 13 times 2, which is 26 over s squared plus 4. Now I'm going to take a look at the capital Y of s's. So I have this and this. Factor out capital Y of s. Then I left with s plus 3 in parentheses equals 26 over s squared plus 4. Now what about this? So you have negative y of 0 and y of 0 equals 6. So we have negative 6. Move it to the other side, which I get positive 6. Okay. Okay, now I'm going to divide both sides by s plus 3 to get capital Y of s along. So divide it on both sides, I get 26 over s plus 3 times s squared plus 4 plus 6 over s plus 3. Okay. Now for this one, we have to write it in symbol fraction form. So to do that, we are going to use partial fraction decomposition method. Let me work aside here. So I have 26 over s plus 3 times s squared plus 4 equals a over s plus 3 plus bs plus c over s squared plus 4. Why for this one I have only a, but for this one I have bs over plus c. So because this is an irreducible quadratic, so I have to account for every single term of s that less than 2, which means that I have s to the first and s to the 0. So b could be 0, that means that we have only a constant on top, but it could be a non-zero number, so we have to account for every possibility. Same for this one, we already account for the s to the 0, so just, that's why it just has a constant on top. Now I'm going to multiply by the denominator on both sides, because the denominator is the LCD. So on the left side I get 26, on the right side I get a times s squared plus 4 plus bs plus c times s plus 3. Now, I'm going to take a limit as s approaches negative 3. Why? Because if I do that, I can eliminate this. So on the left side, I get 26. On the right side, it eliminates this. And I left with this, so negative 3 squared 9 plus 4, 13a. Then a is equal to 2. So very quickly, I get the value of a. Now there's no more term, no more simple factor that we can use the limit. So we have to fall back to using equating coefficients. Let's take a look at the leading coefficient of s squared. On the left side, I have 0. On the right side, I have a s squared plus b s squared. Since I know a, I can find b easily, which is negative 2. Now let's take a look at the leading coefficient of s to the 0. So you can do it in order, s to the first, s to the second, s to the first, s to the 0. But because I need to find the constant term, so I just take a look at the s to the 0. It's much easier for me. It's up to you. S to the 0 on the left, I get 26. On the right, I get 4a plus 3c. I know a, which is 2. Then my c is going to be 8. 4 times 2 is 8, 26. 8 is 16. Right, is that right? 16, so I have 26 minus 4 times 2, which is 8, then I get 18 divided by 3, which gives me 6, so c equals 6. Now I'm going to plug these into here, so this is the same as this, so this can be rewrite as a of s plus 3, and a is equal to 2 plus bs plus c over s squared plus 4. I'm going to break this out into two fractions, bs over this and cs over this. So plus bs over s squared plus 4, b is negative 2, so you have negative 2s, plus c over s squared plus 4, and c is equal to 6, so you have 6, plus, rewrite this, don't forget this term, okay, 6 over s plus 3. Now I'm going to apply the L inverse on both sides. So on the left side, I have y of t. On the right side, I have this. Factor out 2, L inverse of 1 over s plus 3 is equal to e to the negative 3t. Minus factor out 2, inverse of s over s squared plus 4 is equal to cosine 2t. Now for this one, factor out 6. And inverse of 1 over s squared plus 4 is equal to 1 over half of this number here, which is 2, which is 4, so we have a half of 4 is 1/2 psi 2t. Okay, factor out 6, so plus 6, and L inverse of 1 over s plus 3 is equal to e to the negative 3t. Now let's simplify a little bit, so I have this and this, combine them together, which gives me 8 e to the negative 3t minus 2 cosine 2t, plus simplify this, I get 3 psi 2t. So this is my final answer. That's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.